Just one informational footnote for those who may not know that Transcarpathia, Subcarpathian Rus, has approximately 150,000, 160,000 Madyars living in compact villages in the southwestern part of Subcarpathian Rus. So they function as a minority in Ukraine and a minority in Subcarpathian Rus. In Ukraine, we're talking about.
Як повів тепер пан Магочий, що деяка частина населення, однобити 15% на Подкарпаттю, є мадяри.
So, as I just said, it's about 15% of the population of Transcarpathia are Madyars.
До 70% русинів, до 70%.
Perhaps about 70%, up to 70% are Carpathian Rusins.
Значить, мадяри і русини на Подкарпаттю мають 85%.
So together, Rusins and Hungarians have about 85%, represent about 85% of the population.
Уєдно то є 1 мільйон людей.
So close to a million people.
Ті два народи.
These two peoples.
На такому рівні, як одна родина, друга родина, ніде ся не вадили.
On the level, at the family level, have never had any conflict whatsoever.
Ми могли сказати, що мадяри злі, мадяри говорили, що русини теж недобрі, але ніде не було ані одного конфлікту.
Yeah, we can say at the popular level, he's a Madyar, he's terrible, this Rusin is not good, but in actual fact, we've never had any conflict.
І та сама ситуація у русинів із многим, із скоро сусідськими сусідами.
And this is the same situation on the part of Rusins vis-a-vis all of our other nationalities living in Transcarpathia.
Ми не пам'ятаємо, коли русини бися били з словаками.
When did Carpathian Rusins ever fight against Slovaks or vice versa, even though they may have comments about them?
З румунами.
And with Romanians, whether they ever fight against them.
Русини щасливий народ.
In that sense, Rusins are fortunate people.
Ми не маємо скоро ані одного врага.
We hardly have any enemies.
Тисячу років ми не маємо ані одної проблеми національної, міжнаціональної.
For a thousand years we've never had any internationality problems.
То не проблема, ми можемо в телевізії бачити за проблеми, які є в других регіонах, але ми того не маємо.
And so we can see problems in other regions, you know, but we don't have these kind of problems.
Інша проблема – ностальгія.
On the other hand, is a question of nostalgia.
Каждый из нас має ностальгію.
Each of us have some kind of nostalgic views.
Ми хочемо ще раз, як було, коли ми були молоді.
We like each of us as individuals.
Часть мадярів.
Some of us would like to be like we were when we were young.
Часть мадярів в Будапешті хоче, щоб усе було так, як то було, коли було.
And so there's a portion of Madyars in Budapest. Like to see the political situation like it was long ago.
Це цілком нормально.
This is a normal phenomenon.
1%, 2%. Хочуть мати велику мадярщину.
So a small percentage of Madyars would like to recreate a greater Hungary.
А мусимо бути чесними.
And we should be honest here.
То ті 2% русинів хочуть мати свою державу.
And there are about 1 or 2% of Rusins who also would want to have their own state. That would not be
Slovakia.
That would be neither Hungarian or Slovak.
Других.
Or any other.
А то 2%.
But this is only about 2%.
То значить, що та проблема, котра екзистує днесь у пресі, а в телевізії, то є скорше проблема політики.
And so this so-called problem or question that exists in the press is really a political issue.
Я би видів корінь тої проблеми у Москві.
And the source of that problem I would think one could find it in Moscow.
Декілька років тому Москва почала політику.
But several years ago Moscow undertook a policy.
Щоб всі історичні сусіди України,
that all historical neighbors of Ukraine,
реанімували політику ревізії. Ревізіонізм.
To encourage among all the neighboring states, actually, of Ukraine, a policy of revisionism.
Руські не були успішні у Польщі.
The Russians were not successful in Poland.
щоб Польща претендувала на Галичину.
The Russian government was not successful in convincing the present-day Polish government to make revisionist demands to get back the province of Galicia.
Це Румунія на Южну Буковину.
And with regard to Romania and southern Bukovina, which is, well, southern Bukovina is the Ужев. No, I still have to tell you this.
На Буковину.
Yeah?
No, Румунія, щоб не претендувала на Чернівці.
Ага, so that Romania shouldn't be, they weren't successful in convincing Romania to make demands for the rest of Bukovina, which is in Ukraine. So his policy failed in trying to encourage the neighbors of Ukraine to make demands on Ukraine. It failed with Poland, it failed with Romania. With regard to Hungary, however,
то самоє Будапешт мав претендувати на Закарпаття, Закарпатську область.
According to Putin's scenario, Hungary should make demands on to get back Transcarpathia.
І тоді би Путін в'їхав на білому коньові в політику.
And so if all of these demands were fulfilled, then
Then
Putin would come out looking as the big hero
Україна
on a white horse, that Ukraine doesn't exist, it's going to fall apart, disintegrate.
Часть до Росії,
part of it goes to Russia,
часть до Румунії, до
Польщі,
part
to Romania, part to Poland.
Фактично, корінь зла – то є Москва.
And so, in effect, the source of this problem is Moscow and Putin's policy.
У Будапешті знайшлися деякі сили політичні, котрі хочуть, а ведь хотіли б підняти рейтинг політичний.
And of course it was not terribly difficult to find in Budapest as anywhere political forces that want to improve their political rating.
Главное Виктор Орбан.
And in particular the present day Prime Minister of Hungary, Viktor Orbán.
Котрий нейтрально позирить на політику.
It takes a neutral position on politics.
Партії, котра се називають Jobbik.
However, there's called Jobbik.
За ліпшу Мадярщину.
That is working for Hungary.
І то є 2% тих людей, котрі би хотіли ревізії.
And it's a small percentage, 2% of these people who would like to see a revision of borders.
Але тут є мадяри, котрі живуть на Подкарпаттю.
But those Hungarians who live, Madjars who live in Transcarpathia, that is in
декларують,
Ukraine,
що вони не потребують того.
But they have declared openly they don't need this.
А ясно, 2% може і хотіли б.
Fine, maybe a small percentage might have said that this is normal, like in any society.
Але вікшина
не
хоче нічого.
Yeah, they don't want any of this kind of politics.
Бо от того ж вони будуть жити в Мадярщині.
Because, you know, what, we're going to live in Hungary?
В їхньому житті нічого не змінить.
If we lived under Hungary, nothing would change for us.
Мало того, трансформації все викликають деякі катастрофи.
And in any case, any kinds of change of this kind would lead to very serious difficulties.
Ескалація, війна, так далі.
You know, possibility of war, etc.
Я би повів, що такої проблеми не, така проблема не існує на Подкарпатті.
Such problems with regarding this kind of role of the Hungarians don't exist in Transcarpathia.